I was curious about this because it's not like most people don't know what's available at McDonald's. You know there's fries, you know there's an apple pie. What is this dynamic menu really going to offer?
It's really going to, I think, a way to try to get you to buy more food, which is what McDonald's wants to do. And I think you're right. The average person that drives up to a drive-thru, they have a general sense of what their go-to order is. We all kind of have our order. But this will be, well, it's cold today, so how about adding a coffee on to your order? How about adding on a fries? Did you forget fries? So the dollar here, a dollar there, that really is the difference for them as far as same-store sales and growth. So they're using tech to kind of customize this and get you to buy more.
And the tech focus has been there with Steve Easterbrook since he came on board in 2015. How international does this go? Because I know they're going to bring it into the US. I'm interested because as a recent resident in the United Kingdom, there's a big pushback against getting you to eat more of this, so quote unquote, bad fast food. So are they going to internationalize this sort of digital?
We'll have to see about that. I mean, there's 14,000 McDonald's in the US, and the big thing in the US is drive-through. You know, something like 66% of their sales come through the drive-through.
Wow, two-thirds.
Two-thirds, right? So it's easy, I think, in New York or places like that to think everybody gets food delivered now. That's all about delivery. It's not really the case. People are out in their cars on the weekends and during the day driving around, and drive-through is still incredibly popular. So this is kind of an old school bet to me a little bit. There's obviously the tech piece, but it's McDonald's saying that in the US, drive-through is really core for our business and we want to win there.
So that's really interesting because when I first saw the news, I thought immediately this had something to do with finding ways to reduce headcount and making sure that you don't have to hire as many people to work the counters. This is not that.
It doesn't feel that way, no. I mean, there's been a big discussion about these kiosks, and obviously I think there's a sense that the headcount is going to go down eventually. If we're ordering through a touch screen, there's going to be fewer people there. The companies have insisted this is not the case. I mean, I think we can think for ourselves and realize that there's going to be less people, but, you know, there has to be somebody manning that drive-through, you would think. Maybe they can automate all of that, and I do think that as more and more tech creeps in, 5-10 years down the road, those headcounts will be lower. That is just sort of 1 + 1 = 2 as far as how this is all going to work, but not immediately, I wouldn't think.
And looking at Dynamic Yield, the company that they're buying, they were previously working with other companies like HelloFresh and even Urban Outfitters,
but no idea.
They're now going to only be working with McDonald's and what remains some sort of standalone entity?
Right, so they had some other retail clients because this whole customization thing is a really, really big deal as far as, you know, the retail apocalypse and just getting people the right coupons at the right times. I mean, they know so much about who we are, where we are, especially if you're using the app. So it's really kind of all about getting you to spend more money at these brands and just having the brand be a little bit stickier. So I think this was McDonald's saying, we don't want them working with other people. We have enough business where we can just bring this in-house.